What I'm going to teach you today transformed my films, in my opinion, and I hope it can do the same for you.
Before I teach you this powerful audio tip, you'll need to switch your project's audio to surround sound. And yes, you can create films that have a surround sound mix in Final Cut Pro. Doing this will allow you to have full control of your sound environment, and I'll explain what I mean by this in a second. To change to surround audio on an existing project, press Ctrl+Command+1, head into your library, click on your project, and open your inspector window by pressing this icon or by pressing the shortcut Command+4. With your project selected, hit Modify. Head down to Audio and switch this from Stereo to Surround. If you're starting a brand new project, just do the same thing when setting up. So hit Audio and Surround. Switching to Surround allows you to take full control of your sound design by giving you 6 audio channels to work with. Press this audio meter icon to bring up your meters and you'll see what I'm talking about. We have left surround, left speaker, center speaker, right surround, and LFE, which plays deep low frequency sounds. So let me show you how you can take advantage of this. So what would we hear if we're at this location? Let's start with some ambient sounds. Obviously we'd hear the stream. So I'm gonna use 2 stream river sound effects. Let's trim off the end of the sound effects by selecting them, going to the end of the clip and pressing Option and right bracket. You'll see as I play this out that these sounds are only coming out of the left and right speaker. We will change that in a second. I'm gonna press Option G to create a compound clip with these 2 audio clips, and I'm doing this to make it easier to adjust and animate the sound of the river since these 2 sound effects go together. That way I don't have to adjust 2 clips. Head into your inspector window and make your way down to Pan. This right here is the holy grail for dynamic sound design. Using this will allow you to shape your audio environment so you can make things sound like they're exactly where they are in the shot. The 2 pan modes you'll use the majority of the time are Create Space and Ambience. We'll focus on these for this example. If you want to learn about the others, I'll link another tutorial of mine in the description that talks about them. Changing this to the ambience pan mode will put more of the sound towards the surround channels and less signal to the front and center speakers. And we can see that in this weird thing here. This center position is your viewer or listener, the camera, however you want to put it. This dot is your audio. By pushing it closer to these speakers, you're pushing the sound towards left speaker, center speaker, right speaker, left surround, and right surround, respectively. The more you push away from the center towards a speaker, the more sound is played from that speaker or speakers that you're going towards. The more center you are with the dot, the more evenly the sound is distributed. So when we switch this to ambience, the sound is playing more in these 2 back speakers, which are the surround speakers, and less on the speakers that would sound a little more front and center. So this ambience pan mode is useful for designing audio of different environments and to make things sound more all-encompassing, if you will. Little side note, you'll notice that just by switching this to ambience, our stereo sound effect, which was just playing out of only the left and right speakers, is now integrated into the surround sound mix. The river sound effect should be getting quieter as the camera moves away, so let's adjust that. I could put a fade out slider on the end, but that would drop the volume down to 0 decibels, and we just want it to get quieter, not become silent. So right click and hit Show Audio Animation, or press the shortcut Control A. I'll make some keyframes by pressing Option K, and start lowering the volume of sections to match the camera being moved away from this river here. Now we have a river sound that sounds like it's coming from all around us, and it starts to get quieter as the viewer moves away from it. Then you can just press X here to close this out. So let me show you the more advanced tip. Go to the beginning of the clip and hit the keyframe button in your surround panner. This is going to save any changes that we make to the pan location of this sound. In our shot, the river would sound both up close and personal and all-encompassing, so we'll move our sound so it's a little closer to our listener. That way it's hitting the surround channels as well as the left, center, and right speakers. As we play out the clip, I'm going to animate the sound so it matches what's going on in the visuals. I'll move it a little to the right here, and I'll skip to the end and push the sound so it's coming mainly out of the right surround speaker. If I play this out, you can hear that difference and you can see what's going on with the sound by looking at the surround panner. It sounds like we're actually there by the river. These river sound effects and all the sound effects we're going to use to fill our audio environment are from the music licensing site Audiio.
And this is a good segue into mentioning that this tutorial was made possible by the lovely people over at Audiio. So thank you guys so much.
And if you don't know about Audiio, it has a big list of not only fresh quality songs, but also cinematic sound effects as well. So based on the vibe of my video, I can head into one of these cool categories and quickly download one of their sound effects that are exclusive to Audiio. You can use their sound effects and songs for whatever you'd like, even commercial projects, and even if you stop your subscription with them.
I'll make sure to put a link in the description with 70% off of their Audiio Pro plan if you're interested.
So back to the tutorial, it is important to realize that we'd probably start hearing other sounds as we move away from the river. Most likely some wind, some birds, maybe insects. And I found these two sound effects that will work perfectly. If you press Option S, you can solo select those clips, and this is a really helpful shortcut to use when it comes to sound design. Let's make these into a compound clip, and let's definitely switch these to ambience, since they're sound effects that need to sound full and surrounding when our viewer watches and listens to the video. I'll have them fade in, and I'll change the fade option by right-clicking, and we'll go with the most gradual option, which is linear. Now the birds and wind sound effects start to fill our audio environment a little more as the river sound effect decreases in volume. Now that we've used the ambience pan mode to help our ambient sound effects fill the sound environment, let's use Create Space to add in her footsteps. Create Space is a great general purpose pan mode that I use to place specific sound effects in my sound environment. So when you have a bird in your shot, when there's a car driving by, when you want to make it sound like something broke just outside of the frame. Basically, specific sounds that wouldn't fall in the ambience category. I'll isolate this sound effect by pressing Option S, and let's make our audio waveform a little easier to see by clicking here and selecting one of these. Also, the river is so loud that we don't really need to start the footsteps until about halfway through the clip, which also saves us some time, because with footsteps, usually you have to cut up the steps, find where the person is stepping in the video, and place that step at the right time so it matches up. Since she's starting to the left of the frame and comes more center, let's make her job easier with animating by creating a compound clip with all these. We'll head back into the inspector window, flip the pan mode to create space again, since now it's a compound clip. We'll position our sound to the left side of the surround panner, since that's where she is in the shot, and hit the keyframe button. Head down the clip and adjust the sound position based on her location again. Last thing I'll do is add in a soft riser reverb from Audiio to help add a cinematic undertone. And I'll trim off the end, and we went from no sound design at all to this.
If this video helped you out, do me a solid and press the thumbs up button. And if you're curious to see an in-depth sound design tutorial, click right here. Have a great day, guys.